Winner, winner, bologna and cheese dinner. The Jaguars are going to the playoffs.
Kyle Larin did a little bit of decorating here on our desk. We might have some flair in our hair on our jackets, but you heard Lewis say goals change games, but that goal was desperately needed.
Tom told me he's going to take me out to a steak dinner with all the money he wins with his DraftKings fantasy picks tonight. Who do you got?
That Jaguars defense wants to make a statement that they're the new best defense in the NFL. On the back end, you have the Legion of Boom for Seattle. People are talking about this Jaguars secondary, calling them the Jackson 5 with Ramsey, Boye, Church, Gibson, and Colvin. Look at those numbers and listen to that music. What do you think of that nickname?
Kaka will start tonight for Orlando City. He's back in the lineup, but the injury that he suffered while with Brazil getting ready for Copa America did not slow him down off the field. This past week, it's been very emotional here in Orlando, but Kaká and really many members of the sports community here in Central Florida doing what they can to help those who were impacted by the shooting at Pulse Nightclub 2 weekends ago. Kaká, Shaquille O'Neal, and World Series champion Johnny Damon visiting the victims at Orlando Health, handing out t-shirts and certainly bringing many smiles to a number of faces for people who certainly needed it in the wake of that horrible tragedy. Also, you saw those Orlando United t-shirts. Speaking with some Orlando City officials, they told me they have sold more than 10,000 of those, all of those helping the One Orlando Fund. More than $10 million has been raised for the victims of the Pulse shootings.
With a win today, they will clinch a playoff spot for the first time since 2007. Hello again, everybody. I'm Christian Bruey alongside Pride of the Jaguars running back Fred Taylor. This is Jaguars Game Day Live. You can tell there's some extra emotion in these folks today.
Of course. I mean, you win, you're in. It doesn't get any simpler than that.
9-4 the Jaguars are. The Texans come in 4-9, so on paper, you like the matchup.
Of course I like the matchup. I mean, the first game, they totally dominated that team. And this time around, it's more at stake. You know, we haven't been to the playoffs for a while, since 07. So this is an opportunity to solidify yourself a spot, and I know the guys are up for it.
Let's talk about some of the youngsters on this Jaguars roster that have completely really shined. When you look at the receivers in Keelan Cole and Dede Westbrook, both come up with touchdowns last week against the Seattle Seahawks. How about that 75-yarder from Blake to Keelan?
That was definitely a great throw and catch, and Keelan was able to finish right here. He's just a young guy who has a lot of passion. Talked to Coach McCardell earlier today. He says the reason they're successful is because they're coachable. You know, they're passionate. They know they belong in this league, and he said they're going to be around for a while.
Keelan Cole, an undrafted guy out of Kentucky Wesleyan, now showing out in the NFL. And then Dede Westbrook, his first career NFL touchdown. And then he celebrated with a dance. He said he just came out of nowhere with his family over the Thanksgiving holiday. How about that? No rookie wall for these guys.
No rookie wall, because they're playing with enthusiasm. And when you're winning, there's no such thing as a wall, because you're motivated to get back out there the next day. And Dede, to be selected in the fourth round of the draft, now that was a steal for the Jaguars.
The passing defense for the Texans just 26th in the league, so certainly an opportunity today for Blake to hook up with those guys, in addition to Marquise Lew, who certainly stepped up as well in the absence of Hearns and Robinson. On the defensive side of the football, there's so many guys we can talk about, but with the Texans in town today, we got to talk about the former Texan, A.J. Boye. They went out and signed him this offseason, and he has shined as well. 6 interceptions, right now second in the league in INTs. He had 2 last week against Russell Wilson.
You know what? Ramsey gets a lot of the hype. And rightfully so, he deserves it. And that means other teams are going to challenge the other cornerback. And A.J., he's accepted the challenge. I mean, he's coming up with turnover after turnover, and he's second in the league, as you mentioned, in turnovers. And to be able to gift 2 from former Super Bowl champion Russell Wilson, that's a great feeling.
The crazy stat that was up on Jaguars.com this week, a 26 passer rating for quarterbacks against A.J. Boye.
Wow.
A quarterback
wow.
could drop back and spike the ball every single play, and they'd have a rating of 39. Wow. So just don't throw it to him. But what are your other options as you look at A.J. Boye in his 50 games with the Texans, 6 INTs, and his 13 games with the Jaguars, 6 INTs. Just incredible stuff from the kid out of UCF.